Trump just on live media after they attacked him for disrespecting flag but missed what he really did. The President of the United States is the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, we all know that. The title of Commander-in-Chief means that he deserves the respect of everyone, but especially those in uniform. One of the major reasons that the office of President is so hotly debated is more than just his diplomatic responsibilities. As the head of the executive branch of government, he has the potential to put a lot of lives at risk by asking them to fight whatever battle he deems necessary. Many Americans even avoid the military during Democratic administrations because of the notoriously anti-military slant of that party. That's not the case with President Trump, though. The mainstream media and those on the left really want you and I to believe that President Trump isn't a fit to be president, and they'll use any means necessary. They want you to believe that his offhanded comments are the result of a bumbling idiot, and not well-placed jokes or comments said satirically to make fun of the media who has waged war against him. Today, Daily Mail and others reported that the president made a massive mistake by not saluting the flag. What they didn't know is that what he did was very specific, and absolutely correct. As evening colors sounded during a military ceremony at an Air National Guard hangar, President Trump appeared baffled and asked why nice music was playing during an interview. While speaking with Sean Hannity Tuesday, Trump, who has fiercely made his dedication to the Stars and Stripes known, said when the bugle call sounded in the background, "Are they playing that for you, or for me?" He then confidently joked, "They are playing that in honor of Sean Hannity's ratings. Did you see how good his ratings are? He's beating everybody." He turned and asked the audience. Hannity replied after, "I think they'll be higher tonight, I'm just guessing." As evening colors sounded during a military ceremony at an Air National Guard base, President Trump appeared baffled and asked why nice music was playing during one of his interviews. So basically the mainstream media is, for the most part, populated with those social justice warriors and those who support them. There are a few exceptions, but in general, they like to take shots at the president and his administration whenever possible. So when they found out that he didn't salute the flag when Retreat was played, they thought they had him. It seems the president failed to remember one important American tradition, as he disregarded any form of tribute, even though members of the audience showed their respects by standing together. During military ceremonies, it's commonly known the flag is lowered then raised on U.S. installations as Retreat sounds in the back and service members in uniform are required to salute while civilians are required to place their hand over their heart, task and purpose explained of the official rules. Multiple news outlets reported on his supposed faux pas, in an effort to humiliate the president and alienate his notoriously patriotic followers. While we appreciate everyone's sudden interest in history and respecting the flag, there's only one problem: they got it wrong. As can be found by a cursory glance through Google search results, you're not supposed to salute the flag if you're inside while Retreat is being played. According to one publication put out by an army base, informing their residents how to behave, all personnel driving on the installation must stop. Service members and government civilian personnel will turn off their vehicles and, if safe to do so, exit their vehicles and render the appropriate honors. Individuals outside of buildings will render the appropriate honors to the flag during the retreat ceremony. Despite their best efforts to make the president seem like he doesn't know what he's doing, they only succeeded in making themselves seem uninformed. So the question becomes, when do liberals, who support the anthem protesters, become so interested in respecting the flag? Apparently, it's partially because of the anthem protest that they wanted to catch the president in a disrespectful act. Even though he obviously wouldn't have been intentionally disrespecting the flag the way Kaepernick and his comrades have been, they desperately wanted him accidentally do something they could call objectionable. Trump's reaction to the meaningful tradition, which dates back centuries, was certainly not reflecting of his recent public statements made regarding respect of country and flag. Specifically aimed at NFL stars like Colin Kaepernick, who gained national and worldwide attention for protesting before the start of games during the national anthem, Trump condemned the silent demonstration, which has since went viral on the field among several other sports stars. There you have it, folks. The media isn't worried about right and wrong, they're only worried about how they can make someone they want to take down a few notches look bad. Unfortunately, as in most situations like this, the president does know more than the media. Maybe one day they will learn that and save all of us some time.